Look at that loading screen. How ominous and mysterious. I wonder what it could mean. Could this be the start of a new adventure? A sequel to an adventure? Yes. And yes are the answers. This game is a work of fiction. Any resemblance to actual people or organizations is purely coincidental. It's made by Sega. Why does it sound louder than a Dreamcast? And it's presented by Sega AM2, the team behind, I believe, Daytona USA and Outrun. I think Outrun, anyway. I know Daytona USA was made by them. Yes, I believe so. Anyways, what are we playing today? No, we're not playing Loading Screen the game. We're playing the sequel to a game I did back in 2011, and I'm only now just getting around to the sequel. Well, this is that sequel. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Shenmue 2! Shenmue 2. If you're wondering what the hell Shenmue is, it's a series developed by Yu Suzuki, the creator of Outrun, Virtua Fighter, and Space Harrier. Basically, it details the chronicles of Ryu Suzuki, a man, whose father is killed due to the murderer's desire for an item known as, well, two items known as the Dragon Mirror and the Phoenix Mirror. What they do? No fucking idea. He just wants them for reasons. That's basically all I know. Ryu manages to find the first one of the mirrors, the Dragon Mirror, the Phoenix Mirror, inside the basement of his father's dojo place, and he tries to figure out what's up with it, and throughout the course of the first game, he tries, and people try to kill him over the mirror, because, well, Blondie, the villain of the game, wants it, like, really badly. After a series of events that happened, basically, he ends up heading off to Hong Kong, where this game takes place. Now, if you don't want, if you want a visual representation of the first game without having to watch, like, my entire LP or play the game yourself, there are two ways of doing that. One is the digest movie right here, which is basically a 15-minute version of Shenmue 1, cut up into a montage of plot stuff, and it isn't very coherent, but you can get the gist of it. It's not a very, like, the plot itself isn't very complicated, but there's a lot of stuff that happens in it, if it makes sense. So really, this is the easiest version of, you know, getting caught up in what's going to happen in this game. The other way you can do that is by watching Shenmue the movie, which is an exclusive on this version of the game. Yes, I said this version. This is the Xbox version of the game. Reason for this is that while there was a Dreamcast version released in Japan and Europe, Sega kind of went bankrupt and had to resort to being a third-party company, so they couldn't release that version over here. Well, that, and I think it might have been that, and the fact that the Dreamcast version didn't sell well anyway. Also, it had to do with the company's failure. I think it's primarily the company's first-party failures that drove this to be released on the Xbox over here. Now, because of that, there are a few things that have been converted to our ease. One, we've been given Shenmue the movie, which is basically I think it's all the cutscenes in Shenmue 1 strung together with the action sequences, aka the quick time event moments, as being played by professional Shenmue players. That is really weird. Also, there was a feature in the Dreamcast version of Shenmue 2 that allowed you to bring over any items and whatnot from a completed Shenmue 1 save file. But considering that, Shenmue 1 isn't on the Xbox, basically you get almost every item from Shenmue 1 in the beginning of the game, from what I've heard. Yes, I'm doing this blind, by the way. Mostly blind. I basically looked up any preliminary information I need to know. Everything else is going to be blind. The one last thing is that this is being played on a 360, so there's going to be a few graphical flubs, and maybe a couple of audio ones too, because backwards compatibility with Xbox games on the Xbox 360, not exactly perfect. I'm not sure if Nintendo's backwards compatibility or even Sony's backwards compatibility stuff is that reliable too, with PS3 to PS1 and then Wii to GameCube. Also PS3 to PS2. Anyway, enough babbling, because I've been talking for nearly 4 goddamn minutes. Let's start a new game! Yes. Also, there was a tie-in comic that took place between this game and the other game, and something happened into it. Don't worry, it's not relevant to the overall plot. It's fine. And yes, this isn't 4x3. Can't change it. Well, I could, but it would kind of look ugly. Anyway, boots! Lots and lots of boots! I heard you like boats. Story by Yu Suzuki. And there's a plane, too. And there's our boat. Yes, our boat. Yes, we came in a boat. I'm tempted, and this is going to be your quest. I might upload the Digest movie to, like, as a Part Zero thing. Either that, if you don't want me to, then I'll just link you to the Digest movie uploaded by, a channel I went to during my Shenmue 1 Let's Play when I kind of lost an entire part because of something. I don't remember what the reason for that was. But, yeah, I can do that. But I won't upload Shenmue the movie, because that's like an hour and a half long, and I don't want to bother waiting for a potentially long HD upload of that caliber and size. So, anyway, Shenmue 2, it begins in Hong Kong. To get a summary of what Yu Suzuki wanted to get out of the Shenmue series, basically the Shenmue saga, I guess, is supposed to encompass 12 chapters. The first game was 1, the tie-in comic was 1, and this game encompasses 3. So that's 5 out of the 12 chapters logged. So there's an entire 7 chapters that he still wants to do. He might cut it down in size, considering, well, this is like the last Shenmue-related thing, aside from his cameo in Sonic and Sega All-Stars Racing. I'm not sure if he's in Transformed or not, because I haven't played it. I think he might be. I'm gonna say yes, but I can't write it off as being fact. Okay, then. So, yeah. That. All those words and talking. Aberdeen? Well, isn't there an Aberdeen in England? Or something? I don't know. So, yeah. We're here. Oh, we can do this. Yes. For the record, what I did there was take a snapshot of the current frame.
South Carmine Quarter. Yen 10 apartments. This is where Li Xiao Tao is?
Yes.
First, I need to find one's eye.
So, basically, we was looking for associates in Hong Kong here, and, let's see, is it? No. What's the run? That's not what I wanted. Okay, so, okay, yeah, hold on, I'm gonna have to change up the controls. Select button, was it? No, it's X button brings up. That's the menu, there it is. I was wondering where the menu. Alright, so, basically, wow, that's a bit of delay on the HopHog capture feed. Yes, I am recording with the HopHog for this. Let's see, we're gonna do, this. Let's try this. Does this work? Yeah, that works. Maybe. I didn't get a chance to do anything with it.
Stay and listen to a song.
Okay. Hey,
it's
kid.
A song wishing luck to travelers.
Isn't that nice? And who are you?
Put some money in. It'll bring good luck.
I don't know, man. Oh, God. We got some Mass Effect choice systems here. Okay. For the record... Oh, well, I didn't... Well, I guess I... Can I put it in now? That was an accident. I didn't mean to. Well. Okay, yeah. Okay, now I get it. So, because of the fact that this is the Xbox version, yeah, they didn't really change up the controls at all. I get the feeling that because both the left and the right thumbsticks do exactly the same thing. Yep, they didn't add like a camera support thing or nothing. This is just like a direct port almost, except with a few interface color changes, like the A button being green instead of, you know, crap, what was the Dreamcast controller's A button colored? I need to look at it now. It is red. Yes. Let's change it back to the way it was before. I kind of like that layout a little bit better. Just a little bit. Might be me. Well, no, it was this. Yeah, there we go. Let's see. Ellis to zoom. or is to run, or the other way around. I'll get used to it. What the? No, I didn't need that. Okay, let's stop messing around with the controls and save. Wow. Okay. Yes, we can save at any time. Could we do that in Shenmue? I don't remember. So yeah, because of that, also, I think having... Yeah, this works a lot better. So yeah, basically, with this controller setup, I have to use the D-pad to move and the thumbstick to control the camera. I like camera controls to be on a stick instead of a D-pad, because it's, you know, it's a lot easier to do. Yeah, D-pad controlling is awkward, but I don't mind it on this controller. Alright, are we actually going to get to the gameplay? I don't even know if we will, because I'm just standing around talking. Oh yeah, talking, that's what I was going to do. Hey, who am I talking to? No, I want to talk to you. I want to put the thing in, I can't...
Excuse me.
Okay, that...
You called?
I guess I did. Yes.
Which way is it to Wanzai?
Go through the gate and take a right.
Okay, that's easy enough. So hold on, can we check what day it is? It's the 2nd. It's February 23rd on a Monday of, I believe, 1987 is when when this game takes place. There's a time limit in this game. Basically, we have up until the end of July, I believe, in game to complete
Welcome.
It. Otherwise,
Welcome
we get a bad ending.
Kong. Looking for
oh my
fun?
God.
Do you need a guide?
Oh,
are you
okay.
alone, boy? You need
oh,
a place to stay.
Oh God, okay.
Need a tour? It'll be cheap.
Oh boy. Awkward. I'm going this way.
Hey, handsome! Let me take your photo!
I'm gonna take yours. Oh, I took his photo! God damn it. I wanted to take that guy's photo.
Someone just took a picture of you.
And your point is?
He's going to try and sell it to you later. He'll be persistent, but you don't have to buy it.
That's great.
Okay.
Be careful. Not all people are nice in Hong Kong.
I understand.
What? Pushy and
if you need a place
awkward,
to stay, try that free stay lodge.
Is it free?
Free stay lodge?
It's free, right?
You can always stay there for free.
Good. Phew!
You are so kind.
I was gonna feel like...
You were good to her on the ship when she was scared.
Yeah, this is the side story I was talking about before.
Well, take care of yourself.
Bye. Basically, there's a comic you can get inside, you can get it in-game that details what the hell. Let's see if I can... I don't know what the conditions of unlocking it are. There's a menu that says secret, but I don't know much other than that. Oh, I might as well get a map, too. How much does it cost? Or is it just... $10, okay. Wait, has everything been converted to dollar value? Was it like that in Shenmue 1? Oh no, it says Hong Kong, never mind. Alright, so yeah, let's get a map. We can get a map, right? Ah, there we go. Next button.
A map?
Yes. Buy it! We need one!
This area.
I need one!
Good.
You might not need one, but I sure need one. It's a map of the area, okay. Was it like that in Shenmue 1? I believe it was. Whoa! Okay, minimap. I'm down. This makes things a lot easier. Is there any, like, adaptive things? This is like a modern video game? Alright, yay, Virtual Fighter poster. Alright, we have to exit the gate, take right. Got it. I'm gonna mess around with things first. The hell? Well, let's play with this thing first.
It's $5.
It's $5 for your Sega game. Actually,
I
first
won't
off,
this time.
Yeah. First off, let me check something really quick just to see if I'm right about this. Collection. Yep, that's pretty much every item you can get in Shenmue 1. A lot of Virtual Fighter characters, mostly Virtual Fighter characters. I believe a couple characters from... No. Did Yu Suzuki develop Fighting Vipers? I don't know. Canon characters. Look at him, he's in a little dinghy. There's Space Harrier, Animu. There's this guy. Oh, that's another Space Harrier creature. It's a bird. Yep. I believe that's it. I swear we got Sonic characters too. Maybe not. Maybe they just took those ones out. We can also look at our photos. Oh! Oh wait, these are plot photos, yeah. Check this at the pier. And this is a picture of, I believe, Ryo and his dad. Yes. What else? Oh, okay, so everything is divided up now, good. And the Aberdeen area, we have... Yeah, so... this game seems to be well divided up. Pawn shop flyers, none. Move handbook. All the scrolls, which we don't have any for some reason. Or do we? Yeah, we do. Okay, we have a couple. We have a lot of them. Yeah, basically in Shenmue 1, you started with a bunch of basic attacks, and then as you went on, you either bought or found scrolls, which you could hand in to, I think you taught them yourself, or you went to this place at the Pier to learn them. But basically, they're advanced attacks. And I have no idea what the L thing is. Is that the thumbstick? I don't even... Okay, hold on. Well, that doesn't help. We can also modify the move. But I don't want to do that because I don't know what any of the buttons are. Let's... This is basically me fiddling around with the menu, figuring out what does what. Okay, and this is the items of things that do things menu. I think we got this from... What's her face? Yes, I'm so good with words. We got this amulet. We got the intro. The intro letter, and this thing, which is the plot MacGuffin, or the plot item of it maybe doing something, but we're not sure what. Oh yeah, by the way, Shenmue is a tree. Yes, that's what I was gonna get around to. Right. Okay. Let's have a round at this, and then we'll actually do things.
It's $5.
Oh, I didn't want to. No, I don't want to do this boring chip thing. I want to get the Sega characters. Oh, that's why. You're on the way. Okay, fine. I'll wait. You gonna go? You gonna go? You gonna go? Come on now. Come on now. I'm pretty sure I'll be able to beat this game by the end of the time in which you're allowed to, you know, not get the shit ending. Because, well, let's face it, I think Shenmue 1 started in the beginning of December, and I was able to beat it, like, sometime after Christmas. This is talking about in-game, not actually how long it took me. But yeah, I believe that's how it's gonna go. Okay, come on now, you're being a real pain in the ass here. Seriously, are you gonna get something or what? Are ya? Huh? No? Ah, jeez, okay, fine, we'll go in. We're gonna get ourselves a rest. And stuff. Jeez. Hey there, buddy. How's it going?
Excuse me.
What is it?
I just want to talk.
I'm looking for one's eye.
I have a question for you, too. If you can answer it, perhaps I will answer you as well.
Oh, wasn't that nice?
A question?
Why do rivers flow?
To get to the... Oh, that's not a... I don't know. Why do rivers flow? Well, that's not very persistent. Ocean?
The river flows toward the ocean.
That is correct.
Well, that was half-assed. I didn't even try.
Even the mightiest of rivers started with a drop of water.
Oh, I get it.
Water returns to the ocean, its mother.
Okay. The ocean, its mother.
I recommend you take your time. The river flows calmly. That's why it can flow so far.
I don't know, man. You ever see rapids? They flow pretty goddamn fast.
I understand. Which way is it to one's eye?
To the south, water spouts from the earth. You shall hear the singing of a bird.
I would like it in English, please.
Water that spouts out of the earth? What the heck is that?
It's a fountain. We'll talk again when you have the chance.
It's a fountain to the south. Is that what I'm getting out of that? Oh my god, a button. Oh, hey, I can do that. Yay. We'll do that. I should probably get into the habit of save rotations. Yeah, well, that's a thing. Alright, okay, so this is the button where I can just do that. So now that button acts as the... Oh, okay, so... Well, alright, whatever. Don't know what that was about. Do we have a fatigue? Oh, we just got back. I'm pretty sure we slept on the ship. I should get on with the plot, but maybe one more thing. Thank you. Let's see if we can get a lucky strike. Or what, lucky hit? What was
Which
it?
Which one should I get?
Ooh, Jack Daniels. Yeah, let's get this.
This one.
I don't know what it is, but I'm getting it. Oh. It's not a lucky hit. Or lucky strike. I don't remember what that drink was. But basically, every so once in a while, you get a drink that gives you, like, a token or something. And you can spend it at the shops. But I don't think we're getting it this time. Not this time, anyway. Maybe sometime, eventually. Yeah, that was good, whatever it was. You know, there's such a thing as recycling. Or was that... No, this is 1987. Maybe that wasn't around yet. Man, they're putting so many things in the way just to distract you. This is gonna be the part where I just do stuff, and there's nothing gonna be, nothing interesting is gonna happen. What the hell's that? What is that even? Okay, I don't know what the hell that is. I think it's just the edit what does what buttons. You can edit the mapping
Welcome.
Of the buttons and stuff. I
Have
guess that's what it is.
To find your way to good fortune.
Okay.
$20 for palm reading.
Are you kidding me? Well, I've got to try everything once.
Yes, please.
I see a wide road. There are many cars passing by.
You get hit by
Ahead,
one.
Oh. There is the place that you see. But...
But?
You will lose your money.
Oh, well, I already lost my money.
That's all I can see. Come again.
Compulsive
May
gambling is in your future.
Safe.
Thanks.
Okay, well... Thanks for that, I guess. I don't know what that exactly... Well, I know what that might exactly mean, but I don't know what that exactly means. Oh, well... Suddenly locked camera. Okay, well, I'm just gonna keep going this way. Hopefully it would lead to good tidings in progress. Now we're officially at the Worker's Pier. Okay. Oh, maybe that's what that was the map. Okay, so exit the gate. Did I write it down in my journal? We'll find the place past the traffic, but we'll lose my money. That's not a good thing. Apparently we missed a note or two. Find one she. Told me to stay at the lodge. Yeah, I missed a note. Should I go back? No, well, I've missed notes before and it's been fine. What the? Oh, arm wrestling.
What?
I'm not interested. Wait, is that Armstrong? Oh my god, it is. It's Armstrong from Full Metal Alchemist. What is he doing in this game? God damn it, you're so strong!
Thanks for the money! Damn.
Huh.
What do you want, boy?
Don't call me a boy.
You look pretty strong. How about a game?
How about a tutorial? I mean game.
I'm looking for someone.
If you can beat him, I'll be up.
That's what the old guy said, but he just told me some vague shit that
really?
Didn't make any sense.
Sure, $10 a bet.
A bet?
How about it?
You mean I don't actually get to play it? Or do I get to play it? Ah, well, let's do it. I'm sure there's no morality system in this game, so why not?
Yeah.
Alright.
I don't know what
That's
morality has to do with this, but whatever.
You're Japanese, aren't you? What's your name?
I am.
Yo, Hazuki.
Yo, Hazuki, eh? Okay. Let's go.
Oh yeah, we were in Japan last
Here's
time, weren't we? Yeah,
no, we're kind of... The samurai boy from
A new
Japan.
Challenger approaches.
Yo, Hazuki!
Well, I don't use a sword.
Who's he fighting against? The Mexican villain wrestler who stains the mats with blood. Jimenez Garcia!
Eh, I like Armstrong better. Oh my god, your elbows,
on,
man.
Amigo.
Jesus Christ. That's, unnatural.
I'll take it easy on your boy.
Alright, let's see. Oh, it's a button masher. Okay, press the controller button that corresponds to the, so, yeah, basically
Didn't
it's
ask.
A button masher. That's easy enough.
Ah, you wish you did.
Alright, well, whatever.
You fight, and then you begin. Here we go. Ready, and fight!
Hey. Take that! My button mashing skills are unmatched and unrivaled in any country, anywhere! Take that!
Holy.
God damn it! You broke my arm! I mean, it was already dislocated to begin with, but damn!
That was terrific. Here's your money.
Now, help. You're gonna give it to me? Or no?
This is where I want to go.
Wanzai. Go straight down the street.
Cool.
At the end of it, you'll find an old man selling bird feed.
Bird feed?
Yeah, he's usually taking a nap.
Lazy bastard.
Then turn left of that spot. Follow that street and you'll get to Wanzai.
Right. I got it.
And I'm totally going to guess that at the end of that street there was a fountain. And also that at the end of this place there was a gate. Alright, so now we got an idea where to go. Guess what we're gonna do? Save that until next time. Yeah, well, there's also a sign that says Wanchi this way. That too. That kind of helps as well. But yeah. Next time, let's play Shenmue 2. We're actually gonna get... Oh, well, no, I guess not, because... Unless this is a temporary... Well, okay, then. Oh, shit! What the hell? Whoa.
Watch where you're going, you punk!
Jesus.
That goes for you too, barging into people like that.
You must be Japanese.
Everybody says that. Yeah. You know what? I am.
Watch out! Here in Hong Kong, you can easily get run over.
By obnoxious assholes like myself.
Wanzai.
Oh, it's that way.
Can't you read the sign?
I see.
Seriously, there's a sign right there that says Wanzai.
Hey,
seriously.
What's your name?
Yo.
Yo, I'm Joy. You better watch out. There's lots of thieves here.
Well, okay then. Odd. Anyway, like I was saying, hopefully we don't get interrupted by another goddamn cutscene while I get this map. Jeez. Next time, let's play Shenmue 2. We're going to be actually doing some... it's a map of this area. Okay, well, next time, let's play Shenmue 2. We're going to hopefully be doing some actual, you know, advancement of stuff. Oh, hey, look, there's a fountain. Well, there you go. I guess that's where we're going next time, is over there. And then we're taking a left down the street where the birdseed dude is. So until then, see you later, and goodbye.